Hey friends, today we're talking about variance, which is my very favorite feature. Unless anyone else asks you. I do not have favorites. They are all my favorite. It's variance. Variance, my favorite. Okay, so let's get into it. What are variants? First of all, you're gonna need to understand components in order to get into variants. If you don't quite get components yet, that's okay. I'm gonna link you back to a video below that explains components a little bit so you can get a little bit more familiar with that. So go ahead and watch that and then come on back. Hi, you're back. Great. Okay, let's get into it. What are variants? Variants are essentially variations of a component. So if you have, say, a button, for example, and you have a primary and secondary and tertiary button, and then you also have a default hover focus disabled state, and then you also have a small and a large, those are all variations of that component. And when we set them up as variants, it's going to be a lot easier for us to use this component. So let's get into it. Let's compare just components versus variants. I have two different kind of sets over here. I have our components, our individual components on our left, and then I have our variants on our right. If we look at them, they look fairly similar. The differences that I really see right off the bat are that on my left with just my components, I can see each individual name for each individual component versus on my right, I can see just button, just the component set name, and then I can't see each individual name. Other than that, I have all of the same buttons created. They're all kind of organized the same way. They look pretty similar. So now let's get into comparing each individual one. So on my left again, I've taken a button from this set of components over here. So one's done individually as components. And on my right, I've taken a button from my variants. Now, if you were to ask me on my left to switch this to a different option, make it a tertiary button that's large and disabled. First of all, I'd kind of have to know that those are my options in order to like search for it very quickly. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to be popping back and back, and then I can go into my buttons and I know I want it to be tertiary and disabled and large. Let's make it. Cool, that was doable, but it was a little tricky to have to search back and forth between things. But in the one that I've created as variants, you can see right away in the right-hand panel. So let's just compare really quickly. Left only has this one dropdown versus right has same dropdown up here, but I can easily see now the variants are exposed and I can super quickly change it to, oh, I want it to be tertiary. I think we went disabled and large. I can way more easily see what my options are. So it's going to be a lot more discoverable for people who are using your design system when components with multiple variations are created as variants. So let's create one. Let's start out with our little button here. And I'm actually going to start out by creating just those multiple components in case you're somebody that has already set up your design system this way and you're like, shoot, now I have to redo everything. You don't. There's a really easy way to transfer from just components to variants. And actually how you do this might be one of the ways you want to set it up anyway if you're doing it from scratch. So let's go ahead and do that. I have my button right here and I want to go over the slash naming style because that still is going to be relevant here when you're creating variants from scratch. And what I mean by that is you'll see when we went up here that our components are named with this slash naming. So button slash primary slash default slash large. And basically that is everything before the first slash is what your component set is, what you want the set of components to be. These are my buttons. Then everything after that are different properties of the button. So primary button and then secondary button. Those are all after the first slash. Then after the second slash, default. You'll see after the second slash here, it's hover. Those are my states. Then after the third slash, we have large and we have small. So all of the properties that are the same go after those same amount of slashes, if that makes sense. So let's go back to our button and we'll name it that way. So we're gonna call it button because that's what we want our component set to be. Button slash primary slash default slash small. And now I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate this and create all my different buttons. And I'm gonna speed it up a little bit just to save us some time. But I'll come back when we're ready for naming because that's gonna be important too. Off we go. Look at me, I'm making my buttons so fast and I don't like awkward silence, so I'm singing. Okay, we're back, great. So I haven't changed any of the naming on this. I just duplicated things as I was going. So you'll notice that everything is the same name as the button that I started with. And I haven't made anything a component yet, all still just frames. So I want to show you one way to quickly rename. And that is, I'm going to select everything. Let's start with this second column right here. These are all my hovered states. Right now, they are all default within the name. I'm going to do Command R, find everything that says default, and I'm going to replace that with hover. And now rename, great. My naming is all set there. I'm going to find and replace essentially with renaming. So again, with this row, this I have as small, and I can do this with multiple at a time. These are all labeled as small right now, but I'm going to rename small and I'm going to change that to be large. So now these all say my large buttons. So I'm going to do that with each kind of row and column just to make sure that I have everything the same. Let me speed it up again. Be back in a second. Okay, great. We're back. Now to create these into variants. First, I'm going to create them as just individual components to show you what you would do going forward. So we're going to actually duplicate these so I can show you both different ways. I'm going to take this set and I'm going to select all of these and I'm going to create multiple components. So you'll see now, basically this is where we were at here. We're in the same spot now. You'll also see that as these are still all selected, so even if I unselect and then select them again, as they're selected, I have this option to my right that says combine as variants. When I do that, now they're variants. Now we essentially went from this state to this state just with a click of a button. Let me pause here and show you if you didn't want to do that one additional step as creating components, then combine as variants. If you're just totally starting from scratch, you don't already have them as components. Super similar, you're going to select all of them, and then you'll just go to this drop down in the components up here. And instead of creating multiple components, what I'm going to do is create component set. And that essentially is a set of variants. So we now have the same exact thing, both very similar ways of getting there. Since they're the same, I'm just going to delete one of them. And we'll go back to here. And you'll notice that the properties now are essentially where the slashes were. So let me just grab one of our components from the components that we had over here that weren't in a variant. And I'm just going to grab an instance of that to show us that when this was created with the slashes, I'm going to grab this out of our naming just so we can see it a little bit larger. It was created as button slash primary slash default slash small, which is how we created our naming here. You'll now notice that within the properties, we have button was our main component name. Button right here is how that got that name. Primary and secondary. Primary was after the first slash, so that became our first property. Default, disabled, those were after our second slash. Those were our states. Those all went after our second slash. And then small and large, those all went after the third slash. So these properties are going to be defined as where they come after the slash naming. And the first one is always going to be what your main component is called. To change these, because we're going to want these to be a little bit more descriptive for ourselves, we're just going to double click into here and we're going to call this type because it's a button type. And we're going to call this state and we're going to call this size. And now when I click on one of these and I hold down option to drag out an instance, I have my type, my state, and my size, and I can super easily change these just right here. So one final thing about naming, just so you have all the context here, if I were to go into one of these buttons and I double click on it, and again, I'm just going to take it out so we can see it a little bit easier. You can see that the way that Figma's now changed this naming from the slash naming structure within the side panel is to be type equals primary, state equals default, size equals small. So you can absolutely set up your naming that way when you're renaming your components before you create this component set to make your variants. You could even just start naming your button that exact way. And then the only difference would be that how we had to change all of these names here from property one to type, that would already be in there. So totally up to you how you want to do that naming structure. If you want to keep it the slash naming just because you're a little bit more familiar with it. If you want to type in exactly what it's going to be, basically the X equals Y, A equals B type of thing, totally your call. Both of them will essentially get you to the same state. Last and final thing, I promise. This is very long, but I promise we're almost done. Last thing is you'll notice here I don't have anything with like a Boolean operation. So maybe, for example, you wanted the ability to turn an icon on and off. You can definitely do that as a variant. You could say icon equals on, icon equals off. But I would actually suggest doing it with a component property because once variants came out, we realized lots of things are happening with Variant. We're getting a little bloated here. We need another way to fix these, especially with the Boolean properties. That's where I would suggest looking into component properties. It's going to drastically decrease the amount of variants that you even have to make and just make it a lot easier for you and still be able to show Boolean properties like on or off and a lot more things. So I'll also link that video below so you can check out component properties, because that's going to be another game changer for you. Super fun. All right, hopefully this helps, and see you soon.